What's up, everybody? All right, so everyone's talking about how realistic the Pitt is, and that is totally true. But I think also they have some very interesting clinical pearls or important things that we can really learn about how to make healthy decisions in certain situations. So the one that I'm going to look at today is a patient who has rhabdomyolysis. So an athlete who's exercising really hard now comes in with sore muscles, and we'll see what happens.
Go after the Rochester Marathon.
Okay. Any falls or injuries?
Just tired, sore muscles.
Yeah, I'd be in bed for a month. Was this your first triathlon?
God, no. No, I do one every few months.
Have you seen a doctor yet?
No. I went for a run this morning. Had to quit after a minute. Pretty short of breath.
This goes under your tongue.
So you can tell that she's a little
We're gonna check a few labs
cautious
and an
with
EKG. Try
the
right
symptoms
across
he's
the top.
reporting, getting short of breath quickly, having to quit early.
Temp 98.2.
Take a deep breath from me, Otis.
A little pink right now, okay?
Otis? Otis? Didn't take him for a lightweight, huh?
And so what she thinks is happening is that he basically had a vasovagal reaction. So for certain patients, it's very common when you get stuck with a needle, you're giving blood, that they actually just pass out. And so when she said a lightweight, oh, it's probably just a vasovagal reaction. You can see she's checking for a
Oh, shit.
pulse.
No pulse. Crap! Heart
Says
rate
no pulse, so
flat!
calls for the crash card, is not doing a code. And other people have talked
Let's
about
check our
this.
rhythm.
So for
Two
what
way
it's worth,
pads.
with basic life support, if there's no pulse within
Cyclic
10
paddles.
seconds, that means a definitive pulse, you start chest compressions. That is the thing to do. But everything else about
VTach.
this is
RP
accurate.
200. Charge clear.
So they should be doing chest compressions, but the
Expecting normal
treatment
sinus.
is, when you see
Need a
that
gurney in
ventricular
here.
tachycardia on the screen, is to do an
So what's the plan?
immediate
I
defibrillation
see.
if possible, if there's no pulse. So let's say real quick, so what did they notice and how do they know there's a problem? Well, basically, the way our heart normally conducts electricity is it's called normal sinus rhythm. And essentially, the heart has four chambers. There's two small, sort of weak chambers. They're called atria, and they're really designed to kind of fill up the heart. Then there's two big, strong muscular chambers called ventricles, and they actually eject blood from the heart to go to the rest of the body. So the idea is when electricity is being transmitted in the heart, usually the two atria beat first, they fill up the ventricles, and then the ventricles eject blood. So it's normal sinus rhythm. Atria, then ventricles. When you have ventricular tachycardia, the electrical signal is actually starting in the ventricles and then kind of looping back on itself or going really fast. So those two big ventricles are never able to fill up with blood normally and eject it out to the body. And so you just have this immediate, we call it hypoperfused state, or a state where no blood is effectively getting to the vital organs. And so he lost consciousness and essentially had a cardiac arrest.
Otis Williams, healthy 31-year-old, VTach arrest 2 weeks after triathlon. NSR with one shock.
Pulse 98, VP 110 over 60.
He's a little young for an MI, huh?
Actually, right. What's the differential, Dr. Collins?
Drug overdose, electrolytes, on QT. Oh, Borgata syndrome, WPW.
How you doing there?
And so the points they made are really great. Yeah, normally when you have VTach or a cardiac arrest, it's often older people who have coronary artery disease, and you kind of see this coming from a myocardium or a heart muscle that's not getting enough oxygen over a period of time. And so it's weird for a 31-year-old who's a triathlete to have this happen.
Otis.
Okay.
What happened?
VTach again.
Just
200
again.
joules.
Charged
So
and
similarly,
clear.
they should be doing chest compressions
Back in
immediately,
sinus.
but converted
Otis?
back.
Otis?
Oh, groaning's good. 5 of nasal O2, CBC, CMP, troponin, and D-dimer.
What are you doing?
1 gram calcium gluconate, IV push.
We don't have the labs back.
Look at the monitor. YNQRS and peak T waves, hyperkalemia.
And so basically what they're saying there is, you know, the resident provider is saying, hey, we need more information before we do this. And he's saying, no, you know, there's something on the waveform of the EKG, which is classic for hyperkalemia or high potassium level, and wants to treat it immediately. And it makes sense, you know, for the VTach to happen one time, okay, but for it to recur, to happen a second time or a third, that's concerning and makes you want to act quickly.
Intense exercise caused muscle breakdown, rhabdomyolysis, knocked out his kidneys. Now he's not clearing potassium. I bet it's over 7.5.
Wait 2 minutes with you.
If you do the rest of you, we might not get him back.
Athena, you could kill him.
Wait. Oh, my ass. Not yours.
I'll just say here, you know, I'm kind of with him, to be honest. You know, giving calcium in the setting of a cardiac arrest is pretty reasonable. So even if his calcium level was high, I don't know it would do that much damage, but it certainly could be life-saving if he's right.
QRS is narrowed. Much better.
Potassium is 7.7, creatinine 5.6.
So the potassium is very high, the creatinine, which measures kidney function, is very high.
Must be my lucky day.
Ordering 10 units of regular insulin and 25 grams of glucose.
Why insulin and glucose?
Shift the potassium intracellularly.
Exactly, but the definitive treatment is...
dialysis, alcohol, renal, and get a tech down with the machine.
Have you ever seen a dialysis catheter inserted? Dr. Collins is going to place a femoral quintin under ultrasound guidance. It's an excellent way to learn.
My chest.
Yeah, we had to shock you. You're going to be sore for a while.
You shocked my heart?
Long story. Dr. Collins will fill you in.
Okay, so just to kind of bring this all full circle, like, okay, what do we actually learn from this? So the patient had rhabdomyolysis. So a young athlete was exercising really hard and had muscle breakdown. Normally, potassium, which is an electrolyte in our body, it's a higher concentration inside of cells. And so when there's a breakdown of a bunch of cells, in this case, these muscle cells, that potassium gets released into the blood. So out of all electrolytes, potassium is the one that is probably most concerning to me, where the chance of arrhythmia, or making so that your heart beats in an unusual way or in an ineffective way, is much higher. So the basic idea here is that potassium goes high, it makes the cardiac muscle cells unhappy and causes that deadly arrhythmia. So what's the thing to take away from this? Well, I would say basically that rhabdomyolysis in and of itself usually doesn't lead to cardiac arrest. But what rhabdomyolysis does is it releases something called myoglobin, which deposits in the kidneys and can cause kidney damage. So normally, muscle cells break down, the potassium goes up a little bit, and it's the kidney's job to actually regulate that and to get the potassium out of the body. But when you have kidney failure and the kidneys are no longer able to do their job, then it can go really, really high. In this case, the level was over 7 in this patient. And when it gets to that level, that's when you can have a cardiac arrest. So what's the takeaway? All right, in kids at least, rhabdomyolysis sometimes happens after viral infections, it happens after intense exercise, and then, you know, more unusual things like crush injuries or burn injuries are more obvious, I suppose. And so the basic idea is don't wait until the kidneys aren't working to present to care and get treated. Well, how do you know if the kidneys are working? Basically, if there's urine output, that's usually a good sign that they're working okay. And if the urine output starts to decline, we call this oliguria, or there's actually no urine output, this is anuria, then it means that the kidneys actually are no longer functioning and you're in a very dangerous spot now where the potassium is high, the kidneys can't clear it, and so something like this, like a cardiac arrest, could happen. So the two takeaways, if somebody goes down and you can't feel a pulse within 10 seconds, you need to start chest compressions. And then the second thing is, if you have concern for rhabdomyolysis, so a kid who just had a viral infection, sore muscles, weak muscles, and now less urine output and it's dark colored, you really need to get them checked out to make sure that their kidneys aren't failing.